Good morning. Today we will discuss about the silicon control rectifier or thyristor, subject of the analog electronics. What is the silicon control rectifier, SCR, or thyristor? So, introduction: semiconductors devices. There are some semiconductor devices. One is diode, second is transistor, and third one is thyristor. So, first two devices, diode and transistor, we have already discussed. And now we discuss about the thyristor or SCR. So, in this SCR, or thyristor is the most important type of power semiconductor device. So this is the power semiconductor device. And a thyristor is a four-layer semiconductor of PNP N structure. So there are four layers of semiconductors, which are PNPN structure and also 3PN junction in the thyristor device. Junction J1, J2, and J3. It has three terminals. First terminal is anode, second is cathode, and third is gate. So thyristor is the three-terminal semiconductor device. Thyristors are operated as bistable switch from non-conducting to conducting state. This also called unilateral switch. So thyristor or SCR also called as a unilateral switch. The word thyristor is from thyristor and transistor combination. So it was invented in the year of 1957 at Bell Laboratories. There are some thyristor families and also some thyristor family devices. So first one is SCR, second one is trike, third one is dike, and fourth one is GTO. And fifth one is SUS, and next and last one is SBS. So these devices are family of the thyristor or SCR. Now we discuss about the silicon control rectifier, SCR, or thyristor. So in this diagram, there is four layer. One layer is P layer, second is N layer, third is again P layer, and fourth layer is again N layer. So there are three junctions, J1, J2, and J3, and three terminals. One is anode, A, cathode, K, and gate is G. And also the symbol of the thyristor as shown in this second diagram. So we can represent in the symbol form of SCR as shown in second diagram. The construction features of the SCR. So on the base of construction feature, we take here in this circuit diagram two transistor. One is Q1 NPN transistor, and second one is Q2 PNP transistor. The emitter terminal of Q1 transistor is connected to the base terminal of the transistor Q2, and the collector terminal of the transistor Q2 connected to the base terminal of the transistor Q1. So there is a different collector, base, and emitters. they are shown in this circuit diagram by the flow direction is so the flow of current. So this is the construction feature of the SCR. Now we draw the VI characteristics of SCR, or also the graph between current versus voltage of the SCR. So we draw the graph between forward current versus forward voltage and also reverse current versus reverse voltage. So in the forward conduction region on state, there are different gate currents, so as IG2, IG1 and IG0. So IG2 is greater than IG1 and IG1 greater than IG0. So there are different gate currents. And in the forward blocking regions here, as shown in this forward conduction region, that in case the forward blocking region, the thyristor in the off state, and also there is a forward breakover voltage BFOV. So this shows the breakover voltage in the forward conduction region. Now there is also a holding current IH as shown by the dash, and also in reverse region there is a reverse leakage current IR and a maximum reverse voltage VBR. This is the reverse blocking region. In the reverse blocking region, the reverse breakdown occurs in this region. So this is the VI characteristics of the SCR as shown in this diagram, or in this also in the graph that is drawn between current versus voltage of the SCR. So here in this graph, what is the latching current IL? So latching current is the minimum value of anode current required to turn on a thyristor from its off state, and a usually greater than holding current. So this is the latching current of the SCR, and which minimum value of anode current required to turn on a thyristor from off states. Next one is the holding current. So what is the holding current of SCR? The holding current is the minimum value of anode current required for a thyristor to maintain itself to conduction state. So this is the holding current of the SCR. And next one is forward blocking modes. So in forward blocking mode, with anode to cathode voltage being small, only leakage current flow through the device. The SCR is then said to be in the forward blocking state. So in this condition, SCR is then said to be forward blocking state, in which only leakage current flow through the device. And also thyristor is brought from forward blocking mode to forward conduction mode by turning it by and exceeding the forward breakover voltage, or by applying a gate pulse between gate and cathode. So with the help of gate pulse, we can on the SCR by applying a pulse through the gate terminal. So forward conduction state of SCR as shown in this diagram also. The second diagram shows the graph between current versus voltage, that is, so the forward conducting state. So also there is in figure A, so there is four layer P1, N1, P2 and N2 also there. So there is three junction, junction J1 is forward bias, junction J2 is reverse bias here, and junction J3 is forward bias. So this is the forward conduction board of the SCR. Also, when cathode is made positive with respect to anode with gate is open, in that case thyristor is reverse bias as shown in below figure. Junction J1 and J3 are seen to be reverse bias, whereas junction J2 is forward bias as shown in this layer diagram. So junction J1 and J2 are reverse bias, so the depletion layer across the junction J1 and J2 is width is more as compared to the depletion layer across the J2 junction. So the device behave as if two diode are connected in series with reverse voltage applied across them. So this device behave as if two diode are connected in series with reverse voltage applied across them. In this diagram, the graph between current versus voltage, the effect on gate current on forward blocking voltage. So that is as shown in this graph, effect on gate current on forward blocking voltage. So there are different gate currents, IG1, IG2, and IG3, and also the voltage of with respect to different gate currents, also V1, V2, and V3, and also there an holding current and latching current also shown in this graphs. Now we discuss about the thyristor triggering methods. So there are different thyristor triggering methods. So these are some here, and we discuss these different methods one by one. So first is the thermal turn on or high temperature triggering methods, and second one is the light triggering method, and third one is the high voltage method, and fourth one is the dV upon dt triggering method, and last one is the gate triggering method. So here the gate triggering method is very important method for the thyristor triggering methods. So first method is thermal turn on or high temperature. So what is the thermal turn on or high temperature methods? The width of depletion layer of SCR decrease with increase in junction temperature. So we know that the depletion layer of SCR depend on the temperature. So temperature increase, so depletion layer of SCR is decrease. So by increasing the junction temperature, the reverse bias junction collapse, thus the device start to conduct. This type of turn on many cause thermal run away and is usually avoided. Next method is light triggering methods. For light triggering, SCR, a special terminal is made inside the inner P layer instead of gate terminal. So a special terminal is made inside the inner P layer instead of gate terminal. When light is allowed to strike this terminal, free charge carriers are generated due to the breaking of the bonds. So when intensity of light become more than normal value, then the thyristor start conducting. So this type of SCR are called as a NASCR. Next method of triggering is the high voltage triggering methods. In this mode, an additional forward voltage is applied between the anode and cathode. So we applied the additional forward voltage across the anode and cathode. So here anode is the positive terminal and cathode is the negative terminal. So when the anode terminal is positive with respect to cathode terminal, so the junction J1 and J2 is forward wise condition and junction J2 in reverse wise condition. In that case, no current flow due to depletion region in J2 because J2 is the reverse bias. SF leakage current also flow across the J2 junction. So the leakage current is very small or in the range of the nano ampere or micro ampere. So that is the very small amount of the current. As a BAK is voltage across the anode and cathode is further increased, at a voltage BBO forward break over voltage, then the junction J2 undergoes avalanche breakdown and so a current flow and the device tend to turn on even when gate is open. In that case, in high voltage triggering method, this type of turn on is destructive and should be avoided. So this is the process of the high voltage triggering method. Next triggering method is the dV/dt. So in this method, when the device is forward wise or junction J1 and J2 are forward wise and also junction J2 is reverse wise. So the junction J2 we have as a capacitor because that is the reverse bias due to the charge existing across the junction because junction J2 is the reverse bias condition. So we can see this dV/dt triggering in this circuit diagram. There is a junction capacitor CJ1 across the emitter and base terminal of the transistor Q1 and another capacitor J2 and CJ2 and CJ3 is the across emitter and base terminal of the transistor Q2. So this is the dV/dt technique that is also as shown in this circuit diagram. Now we discuss what is the gate triggering method. That is the very mostly widely used in SCR triggering method. In this triggering method, apply a positive voltage between gate and cathode can turn on a forward wise thyristor. When a positive voltage is applied at the gate terminal, charge carriers are injected in the inner P layer, thereby reducing the depletion layer thickness, because this is the forward bias case. So in that forward biasing case, the depletion layer thickness is very small. As the applied voltage increase, the carrier injection increase, so the carrier injection rate depend on the applied voltage. So the therefore the voltage at which forward breakover occurs decrease in this case. There are different methods of selection of SCR. So first one is AK voltage, anode to cathode voltage. Second is the anode to cathode current. Third one is the gate current. Fourth one is turn on time. And next one is turn off time. And next is also package. And next holding current. And last is the operational temperature. So these are the selection criteria of the SCRs. What is the application of SCR or thyristor? So these SCRs used in the AC to DC converters or alternating current convert into direct current converters, and also used in inverters and high power switches. So these are the some application of SCR or thyristors. So next device is the trike. So what is the trike? Trike from triode for alternating current. It is bidirectional device, and this is also have the three terminal. One is the A1 anode, second is the A2 anode, and third one is the gate. And this is also a bidirectional device. So current in the this device flow in both directions. So this is the bidirectional device. This is the so the VI characteristics of the trike or graph between voltage versus current. So there is the different parameters here. There is holding current also, and that is showing in this graph, and break voltage here and forward break over voltage also as shown in this graph. And there is also in reverse region, reverse break over voltage and also a break over current. So this is the so the characteristics of the trike that show the graph between current versus voltage and forward biasing condition and also in reverse biasing condition. And also dike is the two terminal device. This is the third type device. And dike diode for alternating current, which is generally used for AC currents. And this is also bidirectional device. And in this device, the current flow in both direction. So is the two terminal device, that is the dike. And these are the VI characteristics of dikes. These are also so the graph between current versus voltage, and so the on state for positive half cycle, and also as shown the off state in the this graph, and switch or break over voltage also in this forward biasing case, and also in reverse biasing case off state for a negative half cycles, and also there are a on state for negative half cycle that is shown in negative bias regions. So this is the VI characteristics of dike. Now we see in again in track device. So an acronym for triode AC semiconductor. So track is the acronym for triode AC semiconductors. In the track conduct both directions of AC current flow. So there is the AC current flow in both direction. So is the bidirectional device and have the same switching characteristics of SCR. So the switching characteristics of the track is the same as the SCR or thyristor, and also track equivalent to two SCR connected in parallel back to back. So if we connect the two SCR back to back in parallel, so this will be equivalent to the tracks. So the in this diagram that so the two terminal of three terminals of track, and track are widely used to control application of power to various types of loads. So this is the application, and these are the three terminal device. What is the track constructions? So the construction of track is four layer NPNP device in parallel with a PN device. So in the construction there is four layer NPNP device in parallel with to the PN device. So this is the equivalent to the track of this construction, and designed to respond to a gating current through a single gates, and also not equally sensitive to the gate current flowing in opposite direction. So in this that case of track construction, and what is the advantage and disadvantage of SCR and tracks? So we take the current rating and another take the voltage rating of these two devices. So in that current rating case, the track up to 25 amperes. So the rating of current in track is 25 amperes. And the rating of current in SCR up to 1400 amperes. So this is very high current rating in the silicon control rectifiers. And also what is the voltage rating? So voltage rating for the trike, that is maximum rating is 500 voltage, and also the voltage rating in SCR or thyristor is 2600 volt. So these are the very high voltage. So these are the some current and voltage rating of the SCR and tracks. And what is the frequency range of the these two device? So track have the frequency range from 50 hertz to 500 hertz. That is the frequency range of track. What the frequency range of the SCR is up to 30,000 hertz. So this is the very high frequency which is used for the SCR. and trike have difficult switching power to inductive loads. Next, bi-directional or two-directional trigger diodes. So used in trike circuits because they have non-symmetrical triggering characteristics. So most frequently used triggering device is the dike or diode for the bi-directional triggering diode case. And what is the construction of dike? So that is the three layers in dike. One is P layer, second is N layer, and third is again P layer of the semiconductor. So three alternative doped layers here, which is doping by the impurity. The doping concentration around both junction is equal. So there is two junction here, junction J1 and junction J2. The doping concentration around both junction is kept the equal in that dike construction case. The leads are only attached to the outer layers. So there are two leads or two terminals which are attached to the outer layers of the dike. In the dike, the package like a PN junction diode. So after packaging this like a PN junction diode, what in PN junction diode, there is only two layers. One is P layers and another is N layers. What in dike, there is three layers, P layer, N layer, and also P layers. So this is the difference between the dike. What there is two terminals in dike and also two terminals in simple PN junction diode. So a dike has the same effect on current regardless of the direction of flow. So one junction is forward bias and other is the reverse bias in the dike device. In that case, perform as it if contain two PN junction diodes connected in series back to back. So the construction of the dike and as a two PN junction diode connected in series back to back. So the dike has the same effect on current regardless of the direction of flow as on the dike symbol in that diagram. Dike are mostly commonly used in conjunction bed trike to provide full wave control of AC signals, useful for controlling a lamps, controlling for the heaters, and controlling the speed of small motors. So this is the useful of these different devices for the controlling purpose. Now also thyristor can be tested with commercial test equipment or an ohmmeter. So refer to the operator manual for proper setting and reading when using commercial test equipment. An ohmmeter can detect the majority of defective thyristor. it cannot detect marginal or voltage sensitive device. So thyristor includes SCR, triac and diac. These are the also family of SCR. In SCR, control current in one direction via positive signal gates, and also turn off by reducing the anode to cathode voltage to zero. So we can turn off the SCR by the reducing anode to cathode voltage to the zero level. So for use to control current in both AC and DC circuits, so we can use the SCR as a control device for the controlling current in the both AC circuit and also DC circuit. That is the symbol of the SCR, in which three terminals, anode, cathode and gates. And SCR can handle up to 1400 amperes. This is the currents, that is the very high currents. And SCR have voltage rating up to 2600 volts. So this is also very high voltage. That is the rating, voltage rating of the SCRs. And SCR can handle frequency up to 30,000 hertz. So this is the very high frequency that handle the SCRs. In triac, bi-directional triode thyristors, and control current in either direction by either a positive or negative gate signals. So in that triac device, the control current in either direction by either a positive or negative gate signals. And also in triac, we can handle up to 25 amperes currents. So we have the rating of the triac. The voltage rating is the up to 500 volts and can handle frequency up to 400 hertz. So that is the rating of the triac. What required the use of a diac? That is the two terminal device, because they have non-symmetrical triggering characteristics in the diac. So mostly used as triggering device for triac, the testing is done using commercial transistor testers or ohmmeters. So that is the some theoretical explanation and about the different SCR and also SCR family, in which SCR or thyristor and triac and diac, and we have discussed about the construction, working principle, and also the BI characteristics of these different devices. So these are some reference books which is cover the these topics. First one is the electronic device and circuit by the Milman and Halkias. Second book is the power electronics by the P.S. Bhimra. So these are the two books that is the cover of these topics. there are some multi choice questions here, and these questions are very interesting and very important to understand the and clear the concept of these topics of SCR, trig, dig, etc. So here the question first, an SCR has PN junction. So here option first, there are two PN junction. In option B, there are three PN junction, and option third is the four PN junction, and option four is the none of above. So in the SCR silicon control rectifier, totally there is three PN junction, junction J1, J2, and J3. So the SCR is the three terminal, three junction device. In next question, an SCR silicon control rectifier is a solid state equivalent of option first diode, option second pentode, option third gas filled triode, and option fourth is the tetrode. So here the correct answer is option third. And SCR is a solid state equivalent of the gas filled triode. So triode is also have the three terminals, anode, cathode, and gates. So here correct option is the option third, gas filled triode. In next, an SCR has semiconductor layers. So in that question, the silicon control rectifier has the how many layers? So option first is two layers, option second is three layers, option third is four layers, and option four is none of the above. So we know that from the construction of silicon control rectifier, so there are total four layers. One layer is P layer, again N layers, and next P layers and again N layer. So there are total four layers, P N. So there are total four layers. So here correct option or correct answer is the option third, four layers. Next question, an SCR has a semiconductor layers. So this is also a repeated question. And next question, an SCR behave as a switch. So in this question, silicon control rectifier behave as a option A, unidirectional switch. Option second is bidirectional switch. Option third is behave as a mechanical switch. Option four is the none of the above. So silicon control rectifier behave as a unidirectional switching device. In that case, the current flow in one direction only. So correct answer here is the option first, unidirectional. Next, an SCR or silicon control rectifier or thyristor is sometimes called trig, option A trig, option second dig, option third uni junction transistor, and option fourth is thyristor. So, and silicon control rectifier sometime called as a thyristor. So, thyristor and SCR are the same device. So, second name of the SCR is the thyristors. So, correct option here is option 4, thyristor. And next question, an SCR is made of silicon control rectifier is made of option first by the germanium, option second by the silicon, option third by the carbon, option fourth none of these. So here correct option and correct answer is the option second, silicon. So silicon control rectifier is made by the silicon semiconductor. And next question, in the normal operation of an SCR, anode is with respect to cathode. So here option first is zero potential, option B negative potential, and option third is positive potential, and option fourth is none of these. So here in the normal operation of an SCR, an anode is kept positive with respect to cathode terminal. So correct answer is the option third. And last question, an SCR combines the features of, so what is the combination features in SCR? So option first, a rectifier and resistance, option second, a rectifier and transistors, option third, a rectifier and capacitor, option fourth, none of the above. So here the correct option is the second. A SCR combines the features of rectifier and transistor. So these are the some multi-choice questions. Thank you. Thank you very much.